next. The audience is the judge in the case of Scalia versus Scalia, a portrait of the Supreme Court justice opening tonight at Washington's Arena Stage. Jeffrey Brown has our look.
The court has been my theater, and I have the costumes.
In the new play, The Originalist, the first thing you notice about actor Edward Gero is his striking physical resemblance to the character he's playing, the real-life Supreme Court Justice Antonin Scalia.
I tell people what they don't want to hear. That's also what makes me a monster. That's how half the country sees me. Aggressive, combative, law and order conservative. The other half sees me as a hero. Aggressive, combative, law and order conservative. Which am I?
As it happens, both the justice and the actor trace their heritage to nearby villages in southern Italy. Both are from New Jersey, raised in Catholic homes and schools. To really be Scalia, all Gero had to do was take a short ride over to the Supreme Court to watch the justice in action to get the mannerisms down.
You sort of closes his eyes a little bit and heightens his sense of listening.
Show me.
You know, he'll listen, and then when he hears something, then he'll pounce, right? So he sort of gathers up and searching for the right word or for the logic of the argument, and once he grabs onto it, he'll launch and have a question.
Antonin Scalia, of course, is the famously combative leader of the court's conservative wing, and currently its longest-serving member. A lover of opera, which the play uses to great effect, and operatic himself in both charm and bluster,
exquisite,
he's an intellectual powerhouse.
Look, I'm not an ideologue. I am an originalist.
And a firm proponent that judges should look only to the original text and meaning of the Constitution.
To interpret the Constitution as it is written, and as it was understood when the authors crafted the original document. It's as simple as that. Now, the other side of the argument is obvious and wrong. The Constitution is a living document. It must change with the times. Nonsense. Society changes. Fashion changes. The Constitution stands.
Playwright John Strand says he was attracted to Scalia's big personality, but even more to his central place in so many issues in today's public life.
I think most people, if they saw that there was a play with Justice Scalia as the main character done at a theater in the United States, they'd expect to see perhaps a hatchet job on the justice. Because, sure.
You were conscious of that.
I mean, very conscious of that. And it was never my intention to do that. I think that would be childish. I'd much more interested in exploring who he is and what his views are and why he came to those views.
In fact, what Strand and director Molly Smith say they're examining here is the polarization of American politics today.
And I think we are now in a place where audiences and where artists are really interested in the political system. Why? Because everybody sees it as broken. How can we fix it? How can we produce plays on stage that are about this subject?
The play explores this by introducing a liberal law clerk played by Kerry Warren. She's a fictional character, but Scalia has on occasion hired liberal clerks. She's the opposite of Scalia in every way, except in her fierceness.
You are probably the most polarizing figure in American civic life.
Is that how you imagine a law clerk speaks to a Supreme Court justice? Probably? I hold the title, thank you very much. Strike the probably. Have you any other honesty to inflict?
Yes, sir.
Well?
Sir, I detest your rulings on just about every important topic. Abortion, gay marriage, gun rights, executive privilege.
Affirmative action?
Affirmative action. Campaign financing. Especially Citizens United, capital punishment, the Florida recount, and others.
Detest?
Disagree with strongly?
The test is good. Let it stand.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Also...
Oh, God, there's more.
You're a monster.
Do you have a habit of crossing the line, miss?
I don't mean to be disrespectful, sir, but monster was your term. I need to learn about monsters.
Why?
Because we most fear what we don't understand.
The two spar intellectually, but soon enough with respect, even developing a friendship.
I thought if we have people who are at polar opposites politically and let's say even culturally, socially. Then we've got the possibility of exploring through those two characters how you take a step toward the other person with whom you disagree.
Actor Edward Gero has long combined verbal jousting and adherence to historical texts through his many years on stage performing Shakespeare.
As I was watching you do this, the power and majesty, you know, often in Shakespeare plays, and here you are, the power and majesty, the Supreme Court.
Right. There's no question they're analogous.
Yeah.
The focus on language and the listening, the people who inhabit these plays of Shakespeare bear a great respect for the speaker. They're searching for the truth of the argument.
Does Scalia strike you as any particular Shakespearean character?
Well, I know he played Macbeth, I think he's really proud of having done that.
And wait a minute, what happens to you as you put this on?
Well, I have someone put this on for me.
Over lunch recently, Gero got to talk to Scalia about Shakespeare and more, though not about politics or the play, he insists. And as he showed us in his dressing room, he was able to pick up a few more tips for playing the justice.
I love this sort of, this pursing of the, through here. You see it again here.
For all the human focus in The Originalist, there's a lot of actual law, much of it centered on the 2013 landmark ruling by the court on gay marriage. The play uses Scalia's own words from speeches and opinions. People who know him, lawyers, former clerks, legal reporters, helped ensure a level of accuracy and authenticity. As to the originalist himself, there's no word yet as to whether Justice Scalia will attend the play, which he himself is central to the debate.
Here we go.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown at the Arena Stage in Washington. Being